Oh, you were there in yesterday's class. What was the homework that I gave you? I'm asking you, Amal Raj.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the question?
Ma'am, to display numbers
Display, what is that
one,
display
two,
pattern?
three.
1, 2.
Ma'am, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1. Isn't it? Something like that. So let's start with this coding. So everyone should try this code while I am going to write that board. So we'll try in different methods. Finally, we'll get the results. So everyone should try it in your, if you're using mobile, try it in that Pydroid. Others, laptop users, you can try it in Spider, or you can try it in programmers, online software, okay? So let's start writing it. So the question is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. That's the question. Okay. Question is clear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means how many times the loop executes, outer loop. How many times? Achyut, outer loop, how many times should execute?
5 times.
1, 2. Oh, did I give you only till 4 for your examination?
Up to
I mean,
four,
homework?
Four.
Up to 4. Oh, that's okay. Then, no problem at all. Okay. So this is first time, outer loop. Second time, third time, fourth time. So that's clear. So the range of outer loop should be 4. It should work 4 times. Now, J, inner loop. First time when it executes, it should execute. Donna? First time when the inner loop executes, how many times it gets executed? Hello, inner loop.
I guess.
When I is 1, then how many times the inner nested loop will execute? Mohammed Irfan. Mohammed Irfan. Mohammed Irfan. How many
yes,
times?
Ma'am.
Oh, very good. Correct answer. Very good. What does this Mohammed Irfan? You turn, unmute and say the answer. You call me after the
four.
Class. Ah, 4. Is it Mohammed Irfan itself?
Yes.
Okay. It will execute 4 times. Basil. Second time, the inner loop will execute. Basil. Hello. Meenakshi, question will be to the hidden people. Meenakshi.
Yes, ma'am.
Second time, how many times the loop will execute?
3 times.
3 times. Third time, how many? Elvina.
Ma'am, two times.
Fourth time, how many times? Grishma. Okay, that means this is an incrementing loop and this should be a decrementing loop. Yes or no? Hello, yes or no? Yes or no, children? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
It is like, suppose this is your outer loop box. You have how many boxes? 1, 2, 3, 4 boxes. Okay? In each box, in first box, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 balls. Second box, 1, 2, 3 balls. 1, 2, 1. So the different boxes determines how many times the outer loop should execute. In each box, how many balls are there? That is meant by your inner loop. Okay, clear? Hello, is it clear? The concept of loops. So how many boxes? 4 boxes. Here you can see 4 times the loop should execute, the outer loop, I. So this is your I. I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, I is equal to 3, I is equal to 4. And this is your J. J is equal to how many times it should execute? 4 times. Again J, inner loop. Again it executes 3 times, 2 times. 1 time. So this is how the inner loop and outer loop executes. Now let's write the coding. Okay. So there is no doubt that it should execute, outer loop should execute 4 times. Isn't it, Srihari? Any doubt in that?
No.
So as usual, for I in range, the traditional thing in bracket, 1, 5, full colon. Now, what's the speciality of Emmanuel? What's the speciality of J? Emmanuel?
Inner loop.
For J, in range, what is the speciality of J? Is it an incrementing loop or decrementing loop?
Incrementing loop.
Incrementing loop. Wonderful.
No.
Is it an incrementing loop or decrementing loop?
Decrementing loop.
Decrementing loop. So you should start with how many times it should execute the inner loop. First time it should execute, 4 times, second time it should execute, 3 times, third time it should execute, only 2 times, then 1 time. So what is the starting value of the number of values are? Starting number of balls are 4. So based on that, you need to write the coding. So J in range, we can start with
4.
Okay. Then what should we write? Is it 4 or is it 5?
Four.
Okay, let's write 4 itself. Then what will be, what will write here? Comma? What do you think?
1.
1, comma?
-1.
-1. Do you have the compiler, online compiler? Yes. So try this now itself. Whatever you have written, you can try. And print in bracket. Print bracket. What should be displayed? J, right? Emmanuel, question to you. Emmanuel. No response. What should be here, Meghna?
J.
Comma. End is equal to. Then end. Sorry. Print in bracket. So now everyone try this coding in your online compiler. And Krishna Chandran, you can share this screen. Write down this coding in your, so we'll do the trial and, this method is called trial and error method. So you will try it. If your output is not proper, then you will correct the mistakes and try it again. Trial and error method. Are you ready, Krishna Chandran? Do you have any short name so that I can call you? Always Krishna Chandran, very long name. Krishnandran? That's okay. Krishna Chandran is also stuck, I guess. So someone else, Lydia, your connection is superb. Super Wi-Fi connection. We can try it out and you can share the screen. Once it is finished, please let me know so that I can enable the share screen. Do you have a spider?
Ma'am, PY.
Or you can try with programmers.
Ma'am, in PY drawing.
Oh, what is it? So one Achyut's output has come. So Achyut, share screen is enabled. You can share the screen.
I did not get the correct
output. That is okay. That is how. That is the program. Whatever I have written the board, you just copy, right? So that is not the correct thing. You just share the screen and show everyone. We'll do the trial error method.
This is what I got.
This is what we will get when you write that code. Is that a output that you need?
No, ma'am.
No. So stop share screen. So you need to make some changes in the coding. Okay. It always starts with 4. How come, Adithiraj? But our output, we need the output as 1, 2, 3, 4. So what can be the different changes? Adithiraj, tell me one change.
J in range 4, 1.
4, 1.
We should
change to? Okay, tell me the value that
one
you think.
1, 4.
1, 4. Okay. Okay, you can try it out and you can share the screen, someone. Did you get the output? Chat box says should be. Okay, this is just trying. Trial it is. Did you get it, Aditya Raj?
No, ma'am.
No. What's the output you got? Share it.
Ma'am, nothing.
Not. How come nothing?
Yes, ma'am, nothing is there.
What about others?
Nothing, ma'am.
Nothing. In range 1.54, J in range 1.4, print J. How come nothing?
Ma'am, I got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1.
Ah,
2, 3.
Did you try with programmers? Adithiraj and Gauri?
Yes, ma'am.
This programmer has some issues. Close it and open it again. So that's why you're not getting the output. So again, Achyut, share the screen.
Ma'am, can you see?
Yes, yes, we can see it. Run.
Ma'am, sometimes when I'm screen,
yes, the speed yes, becomes there slow. There is a problem with this programmer's compiler. That's okay. The output is not correct. So now what should we do? Every time it is showing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, etc. Because this will work only 3 times. Why, Adithiraj? Because we have given 1, 4. 1, 2, 3. So the first value will be 1, 2, 3. The second value will be 1, 2, 3. Third value will be 1, 2, 3. Fourth value will be 1, 2, 3. This will be your output if you write this coding. But your coding is not like this. See, it is a decrementing loop. That is the correct thing in bracket. What is it? If you're starting it with 4, how many times the loop should execute? 4 times, isn't it? We need to display 1, 2, 3, 4, then 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So 4 times it is executing. So if this loop to execute 4 times for the first time, then what should be the value over here? 4, 4, first time it should execute 4 times. Next it should execute 3 times. Next time it should execute 2 times. That is, it is not a constant. The end value is not a constant. It depends on some other variable. What is that variable? Hello, what is that variable? Adul KK, what should be right?
I
comma minus 1. Now let's see whether this is right or wrong. Adul, can you share the screen? After doing this code, 4, i, -1. Print J and is equal to. This coding is also not correct. Anyways, you share the screen. Then you will get answer 4, 3.
I'm yes. Not getting 1.
4, 3, 2, 4, 3, 4. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
But our output is not that. See our output. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So let me tell you, let me tell you, don't think that always the variable that should be displayed, that should be I and J. You can have any variables inside the loop to display. It is not compulsory that you have to display I, you have to display J. You can display some other variables. Gauri is thinking. See, in our these previous programs, we always use I or J. So even if you write the I in print statement or if you write J in print statement, you won't get the output. That's for sure. Achyu, just change into I. J, you change into I. Will you get the output? Will you get the output?
Ma'am, I do not understand.
If you change J to I.
Ma'am, so two I's will be there, right?
No, my, what I was telling you is, if you change this print J to, there are only two options. That is how you are thinking. Either you display I or you display J. Only two variables are available, isn't it? Diya. So when you add J, when you add J here, it is not coming properly. So then the next option is I.
Now it is showing 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3.
Now also the output is wrong. That means with this I or J, your program will not get this correct output. That means, so think in that way. That means this is not the way, or you need some other variable in order to display the correct answer. If you tried with I, you tried with J, but you know that the first loop is incrementing loop, the second loop is decrementing loop. That logic is correct, perfect. But the display thing should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So we tried with I, we tried with J, but your answer is not correct. So we have to think about one extra variable. Just declare another variable for that if you are not getting. So think in different ways. Did you get the output, Adul? Because I may have a different logic. Adul may have a different logic. So that's what? Adul?
I made the outer loop a decrementing loop.
Okay. Can you just show me your output? Share the screen. So you can use any logic, but you need to get the output. Output loop decrementing you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
That is also correct. Very good. That is a different logic. Okay, that's good. Then you can write J, isn't it? Display, you can display J. So no need of a third variable. Okay, good. Good thinking. Think differently. Only then you will get output for the questions. So he made the first loop as decrementing. So only requirement is the first time the loop should execute 5 times. The outer loop should execute 5 times. So 5 times loop should execute. So it can be a decrementing. You can make it as decrementing or incrementing. But the loop should execute 5 times or 4 times. Are you getting my point? The requirement is that outer loop should execute 4 times. So you can write 1, 5 or you can write 5, 1, -1. Then also the loop will execute 4 times. Isn't it? Yes or no, Lydia? If you write 4i in range 1, 5, it will execute 4 times. That's clear? If you write for I in range 5, 1, -1, then also it will execute 4 times, isn't it? But the value will be decremented. The loop will execute anyways. The loop will execute four times. So you can have a incrementing loop or decrementing loop. But outer loop should execute four times. That is the only thing requirement that you need. Adul, now we can share the screen. Good. Okay, 5, 0. Okay, you have to write 5, 0, not 5, 1. If you write 5, 1, it will execute only 3 times. So see this logic. For I in range 5, 0, -1. So how many times it will execute? First value will be 5. The second value will be 4. The third value will be 3, 2, 3. And 2 and 1. When it becomes 1, it will exit. Why? Because only till 1 it will execute. Now inside the inner loop, he has written for j in range 1, i. So the first value that will be displayed is 1. Then j will increment. So just a moment. Okay, see the first time the loop value here, it will be I value of I is 5. That's correct, right? I's value is 5. When it comes to the inner loop, J's value will become J in range in bracket 1, what is the value of I? What is the value of I, Vidhur? Vithur, what's the value of I? Hello, Vithur.
Yes, ma'am.
What's the value of I? Are you not able to see my screen?
No, ma'am, no.
Oh, okay. Okay, when I's value is 5, what's the value of I inside the loop? 1, 5, right? Okay, you can stop the share screen, Atul. So what he has written is for I in range 5, 0, -1, for J in range 1, I, then print J, and is equal to now we to listen here. My question is, when I's value is 5, are you listening, Vithur?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, when I's value is 5 the first time, then it will enter into this loop. No doubt in that, isn't it? Now for J in range 1, i. So what will be this I? 1, Vidur, 1, are you there, Vidur? Or Lydia, what will be the value of I? For the first time?
Ma'am, once more.
Hmm?
Question.
No, I'm not hearing you properly. Meghna, what will be the value of I?
1, 5.
1, 5. So it will be 1, 5. So if the inner loop is J in range 1, 5, means how many times the inner loop will execute? How many times?
Four
times. So you forget about the outer loop. Just concentrate in this loop. 4J in range 1, 5, print J. Then what will be the output? Print J. 1, 2, 3, 4. Any doubt in that? Forget about the outer loop. Just concentrate in an inner loop. So after executing 1, 2, 3, 4, displaying 1, 2, 3, 4, the loop will exit. Inner loop will exit. Then end. End means new line. Okay. Then the control will again go to this side. Now I's value will be, what will be the value of I, Reina? I was 5. Now it will become
4.
I will become 4 because of decrementing loop. Then again it will enter into the loop body. And what we have written here, what Adul has written there, 4J in range, again 1, I. So 1, I means? 1, I means what is the value of I now? Reina?
4.
If 1, 4 as the slope, how many times this will execute? 1, 4. Reina, 1, 4.
Three times.
So what will be the first display? Just consider the inner loop. What will be the first display?
1, 2, 3.
Then after displaying everything, this loop will exit and print. New line. Again, the control will go here. Then I will become 3. Then it will enter into the inner loop and 1, I. I will be 3. So how many times it will execute? 2 times. Like that it works. This is the easiest method than the other method. The other method, we have to use another variable. Achyut, understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Gauri? Gauri, are you there? Understood this method? What about others? If you have any doubts regarding this question, you can call who? Call Adul KK. He will pick your call at any time. Isn't it? Where is he? Adul KK. About this question. So the other method is we can use another variable K inside the loop and you can increment the variable K. So don't go to that complicated. Whenever I am thinking, I think differently, but my thinking will be always complicated thinking. So this is that is easier than the other using third variable. Okay, we can follow that method. Now one more question is there, that is, I will explain to you. Don't think that I'm making all the programs complicated, but that is an important question. Write a program to find the reverse of a number. That's the question. Write a program to find the reverse of a number. And after finding the reverse, okay, that's all. Just reverse of a number. You just find that first. Then we will move to another. As end the program, we'll write the next thing. Reverse of a number. Have you heard about palindrome? No. Malayalam is a palindrome. How? Read from the right side, read from the left side. The same. That is called a palindrome. This is a palindrome string. Palindrome string, madam. Okay. Now let's see Malayalam words. Palindrome. Now, one 121. What is the reverse of 121, Aditya Raj?
I'm 121.
Same. So we'll call it. We'll call like 121 is a palindrome number. That's why we are doing this program. Ultimately, our aim is to check whether the entered number is a palindrome or not. Suppose the user entered 123. So what is your duty? Find the reverse of this number. Reverse of 123 is 321. Then you will display it is not a palindrome. Okay. And now comes your place value that you have studied in fourth standard. What is the place value of 3, Vithur? We'll go to fourth standard. Yes. Place value of 2.
Tens.
Place value of 1.
Hundreds.
So we will be going to do this program in this way. This 123 can be converted into 100 plus 20 plus 3. Isn't it? So when you find the reverse, what you will do is you will extract the numbers from the right side, rightmost digits we will extract. The first extraction will be 3, isn't it? The rightmost digit. 3 will be extracted and it should become 300. And this will, you have to extract 2 plus 20 plus 1. So 321. That is how you need to find out reverse. So think, you can use a while loop or you can use a for loop, but for these type of questions, since you don't know how many digits the user is planning to enter, better to use a while loop. If you know how many times the loop will execute, then you go with a for loop, otherwise go with a while loop. So just try it out. Okay. That's all. Bye-bye. See you.
Thank you, ma'am.